Hey everyone, what's going on? Welcome to today's video. Let's go to our quest line and see besides Jafar and Kay. Alright, so every one of these ones are Eternity Isle quests. However, Maui has a quest available, and so does Olaf. Okay, let's see who we're closest to, or who's closest to us. That would be Olaf, as he's right in the same biome as myself. Directly across from me, to be in fact.
Oh,
hi! Hello, Matt. I was just gonna come find you. I'm very happy to be back in the village, but oddly, it doesn't feel right. It's like something's missing. I just don't know what. You're older, and thus all-knowing. Could you help me figure it out? I'll try to help. Tell me more. Well, this place used to be full of joy and friendship and warm hugs. But some of the villagers don't seem happy at all, like the grumpy lion and the lady who's always looking in the mirror. Grumpy lion and lady who's always looking in the mirror. Oh, you must mean Scar and Mother Gothel. You can't make everybody happy. What have you tried to make them happy so far? We'll get a smile out of them, don't worry. They're hungry for power. If they were happy, a lot of other people in the village wouldn't be. Wow, so you're saying that some conceptions of happiness are at odds with others, and maximizing the happiness of everyone is practically impossible? That's a very grown-up thought. Let's keep it simple. What have you tried doing to make Scar and Mother Gothel happy so far? Well, I tried to give Scar a warm hug, but my permafrost got stuck to his fur, and he didn't like it. Then I tried to tell Mother Gothel some fascinating trivia. Like what? I told her that the average human breathes in and out 22,000 times a day. She didn't seem to be impressed. Maybe we could try giving them some gifts. That always cheers people up. What an incredible idea! I knew you could help me. You have the innate wisdom that comes with maturity, and I know just what to get them. Let's start with some flowers. Some red bromeliad, blue passion lilies, and white passion lilies would make an exquisite bouquet. And of course we'll need some salmon. Salmon? Why? Just trust me on this one, Matt. It's all going to be a wonderful gift. Why don't you go find everything while I figure out what to write on the cards? Dear Scar. Next one. Dear Mother Gothel. No. To my most esteemed fellow villager.
I just love sunny days. I'm so glad you made it.
We're gonna hang out. Let's have a conversation. Matt, I've been learning so many new things. Like, did you know that a snail can fall asleep for 3 years? Interesting. Did you know that reindeer are the only kind of deer whose noses are completely covered in hair? Bye. Good to see you too, Donald. Let's see. Is something wrong? Hey, Matt, I've been trying to make some good meals. But every time I throw stuff in a pot, all I get is crackers. Crackers, crackers, crackers. Sounds like you need to just keep experimenting. Try some different ingredients. Of course, I'm not doing anything wrong. It's the ingredients. There must be something wrong with the ingredients. Goofy sold me. I'm gonna go give him a piece of my mind. Okay. Let's go get the red bromelade first. Because they're up here. I believe we can get salmon up here too. Let's make sure. Salmon. Oh, Sunlit Plateau and Frosted Heights. Yep. Okay. Oh, where? Oh, ooh, I got it. Oh, my pockets. A mini crop top. Cute.
How's it going?
Tilapia. We're gonna have better luck getting salmon in Frosted Heights for sure. So, let's just get our red. Don't see any more over there. Salmon just might be in the regular white bubbles. And here. And it's on that plateau. Well, and even in the Frosted Heights. Yep, okay. Surprise, surprise, I was wrong the first time. Bass. Good, we just need one more. I think we can go to the Frosted Heights and try and catch it. Yeah. As we're journeying there, let me discuss some plans with you guys. So I do want to bring in the rest of the villagers from the castle. So Buzz, Woody, Simba, Nala, Belle, and Beast. And I also want to work and do some stuff on Eternity Isle. But I want to bring over the rest of the characters first. So, what I want to know from you guys is, how soon should I get to Eternity Isle after I bring my characters in? Because I want to look. So, let me finish my thought for sorry. I want to bring the characters over and I want to level them up so that I can make them time benders. Because the more characters you have in a certain hangout thing, like gardening or time bending, the more they you get when you're hanging out with them. Oops. And right now, or at least when we get to Eternity Isle, we're gonna need a lot of mist. And that's what you get when you're time bending. Not black, but that's not black, that's dead. So I'm at least going to make the 6 characters that I mentioned at least level 2. So that I can give them a hangout task, I guess. And whether they're all time bending or not, I haven't decided yet. I'm thinking so, but maybe not. And actually, as Ursula is standing right next to me, or swimming next to me, get over here, you evil witch.
Gorge, I could use some help.
No, I want to talk to Ursula. Because... Oh.
Goodbye, dear.
Oh my heck. Can I use the right thing? I need to assign Ursula a hangout. She needs to be human. Scrooge and I are competing in a fishing competition. Who's gonna catch the fish? Of course it's gonna be me. Oh good, we got our last one. And here's our last white lily. Bring them to Olaf. You did it. You found the salmon and the flowers. Hey, did you know that together salmon and flowers are an anagram for fall, more snow? I did not know that. That's okay, I find that most people don't. Come on, let's go give Mother Gothel her gift. I think she's gonna love it. All those who haven't done this quest yet and are watching this video, have you figured out what Olaf's gonna do? Come on, snowman. Keep a walking. Keep a walking. Hello, Mother Gothel. We've got a very special gift for you. Yep, he gave her the salmon. Raw fish? Why would you possibly want to give me raw fish? Because I thought you'd like them. Did you know that salmon change color and have an excellent sense of smell? How nice for them. Now run along and stop pestering me with the useless nonsense. I'm not surprised that my gift didn't make Mother Gothel happy. Oh, I'm so surprised. I thought you were going to give her the flowers and scar the salmon. I think things got a little mixed up. Yeah, making everyone in the village happy is going to be harder than I thought. Have to keep trying. You're right. And we'll start by delivering this bouquet to Scar. I'm sure he'll love it. I don't know if Scar would like it very much. Really? These flowers definitely say King of the Jungle to me, or at least jealous uncle of the King of the Jungle. Why don't I bring Scar the flowers so he can be a little... he can be a little grumpy. Okay, but be sure to tell him they're from someone who wants to make him smile. Sure, well, meet you near the bridge on the Sunlit Plateau after. I am not quite certain what Miss Mother Gothel is doing. Let's have a conversation. Matt, I feel that I must share a bit of my knowledge of the world, so you have a chance to survive out here on your own. Now, you must have noticed the flowers growing around the village. So beautiful and majestic, like me. I love flowers. Of course you do. After all, who doesn't? You must remember that every part of the valley is home to one or two special types of flowers. Some flowers are even grow in the sand on Dazzle Beach. Hydrangeas and sunflowers, to be exact. Let's see. Glass, emerald, and red passion lily. Okay. Oh, fairy godmother. That was creepy. Oh my goodness. Where's Scar? Okay. Directed.
Over here.
If you be so kind. Oh, hello.
Hey, Scar. So, I've got a gift for you.
No.
A raggedy bunch of flowers. Surely you aren't fool enough to gather these for me yourself. They're from Olaf. He really wants to make you smile. Pass on my appreciation for these pedestrian posies. And then tell that clawing little snow sculpture that if he pestures me again, I'll turn him into slush.
You may leave now.
Meet Olaf at the bridge in the sunlit plateau. Okay. I don't know where he's going, but we'll meet him there. You gotta love a place where you never know what's gonna happen next. That's for sure.
Hello.
So, did Sky like his bouquet? Oh, definitely. I don't think so. But those flowers were so beautiful. Wow, it really is tough to make some people happy. I just wanted to bring joy to the whole village. Olaf, something happened. I think everything we did together is making new memories appear.
Hands down, this is the best day of my life.
That's it. That's what's missing from the village. Stories. Before the forgetting, I was the official village storyteller. That's how I brought joy to the village. And there used to be a great big stage in the Frosted Heights. and everyone would gather around it, and we'd put on plays. There isn't any stage in the Frosted Heights. It must have been destroyed during the forgetting. Oh, how sad. Don't be sad. We'll build a new stage. It'll be just as good as the old one. We will, thank you, and I even think I remember how we built the old stage. We used some softwood, iron ingots, and rope. I wonder where we got the curtains, though. I know someone who could help us with that. Minnie, she's great at all sorts of creative things. Okay, let's gather everything up, make the stage, and start telling stories again.
Did you know books are the windows to the world? I wonder what the doors
are. That's cute. Books are the windows to the world. I like that. For rope and talk to Minnie. Donald, I have a feeling you are following me, and you shouldn't be. Where's Minnie the Mouse? Minnie the Mouse. Minnie the Mouse. Minnie the mouse is right here.
The villagers are depending on you, my friend.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. What up, Kristoff?
Great how nice you are to everyone.
Okay, where are you going? Oh, is she home? Nope. She's a fishing. Why, hello, Matt. It's so nice to see you today. Is there something I can help you with? Do you have any curtains you can spare? It's for Olaf. We're building a stage. A stage? Oh, how exciting. I know. I can't wait to watch Olaf's plays. Help with Olaf's plays. Oh, Mickey and I used to love watching Olaf's plays while he sipped hot cocoa. And you know what? It's your lucky day. I just picked up some new curtains from Uncle Scrooge. And I have a little extra fabric. Thanks, Minnie.
I can, how sweet.
Crafting the stage. I'm so glad she was so close to this crafting bench. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Bring the stage to Olaf, who is no longer following me. Where is this snowman now? Oh. Still hanging out there, huh? Oh, Ursula. Princess of what? I have great neighbors.
Oh, hi!
Wow, very impressive craftsmanship, Matt. But let's not put the stage up until we're ready to start the show. Now that we have a place to tell stories, we just need to find some stories to tell. Don't worry, Dreamlight Valley is full of stories. I know we'll find something. Thrilling and action-packed, dreamy and romantic, scary and chilling. Oh, I'm on the edge of my seat already. I'll do some pondering about this and let you know when I'm ready to begin, Matt.
Well, I guess that's it. Bye!
Alrighty. Oh, another quest. Matt, just who I was hoping to see. How would you like to help me tell a story that's sure to dazzle all the villagers? Well, I've been searching everywhere for a great story to tell. First, I talked to a very friendly squirrel. Then I talked to Wally. Then I talked to Merlin. What did the squirrel tell you? Oh, it made a loud screeching noise and ran away. Though I'm not sure how that story will play with our audience. He said, "Wah." He's a machine of few words. Well, Merlin always knows the best stories. Probably because he's magical and also the best aged person I know. He told me all about how you're fighting the forgetting, and I decided that our story, The Legend of Matt, you want to put on a play all about me? Phew, I thought you were. For a second, there would be a sudden fame that sure to come to bring the subject of our topic, Epic Tale. Let me read that again, that was weird. I thought for a second there you wouldn't want the sudden fame that's sure to come with being the subject of our epic tale. Okay, I'm listening. Matt, please regale me with your feats of heroism. Spare no detail. Well, okay. It all started when I fell asleep under a tree and... Wait, you can't have a story time without a snack. A snack? What are you hungry for? Oh, being a snowman, I don't need to eat. I'm just thinking of you. Maybe you could ask Remy. He knows all about yummy food. I bet he'd know the perfect snack for story time.
Hands down, this is the best day of my life.
Alright. Well, let's have you follow me again. And now let's go find the Remy. Remy-san. By the wishing well. Creepy fairy godmother making faces at me.
Hello.
Huh? So you're looking for the perfect snack for story time. Say no more. When I think of stories and snacks, one thing really pops to mind. The flickering lights of a cinema screen. The smell of salted butter. You, my friend, need popcorn. And for the perfect popcorn, you'll need corn and butter. Great, thanks, Remy. Wait, you said Olaf will be there. Well, I know how to make the recipe extra special. You'll want to throw in some sugar cane. Oh, and you'll need to get some pure ice. That's the secret ingredient. I'm sure Elsa would be happy to help with that.
Thanks.
Alright, so I need another corn and I need butter. We can get the butter. Let's talk to Elsa.
Uh-huh.
You're making a snack and Remy told you to get some pure ice? That's interesting. Well, who am I to question the master chef? Here you go.
Goodbye.
Okay. Let's see if there's any corn growing over here. Fingers crossed, there's not. Okay. Well, oh, there is. I'm just blind. Alright, we go back to the restaurant. Ursula.
Oh, you poor, unfortunate soul.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
You know,
I made her mine.
Really like it.
Okay.
Hello.
My bad. For some reason, I thought that I hadn't.
Oh, don't be afraid, dearie. I wouldn't hurt a dummy.
But that's okay. I guess I had to level her up, didn't I? Ba 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 butter. Cook Olaf a snack. Corn, butter, sugar cane, and pure ice. Oh, right there on top. Bring the popcorn to Olaf. Whoa, that's a close up. Matt, that smells delicious. Now everything's ready for you to tell your story. Regale me. Okay, so it all started when I fell asleep under a tree in the woods. And that's it. That's everything that's happened to me since I arrived in Dreamlight Valley. That's one of the top three best stories I've ever heard, Matt! My favorite part was when you jumped into the portal to go find Donald Duck. The valley has so many heroes, and if I'm going to write this story, I need to know every tiny little detail. What happened on Kristoff and Donald's epic adventure? How did Kristoff survive in the woods the whole time Donald was missing? I must know everything. I guess we could go talk to Kristoff and Donald and ask them. Great idea. Why don't you do that while I start to figure out the first act of the script? Act one. Whoops. Sorry. Alright guys, we're going to continue this next time. Hey, thanks for joining me today. Like, subscribe, and comment down below. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye, friends.